I want to ask you just for a moment about the what do we do about this side, which is the governance side, right? We don't really have a regulatory environment yet. The government actors don't know a lot about the stuff that you know a lot about yet, maybe ever. You know, the architecture is not there, the institutions aren't there. Give me just for a moment where you think the beginnings of effective governance or regulation would come from in this environment.
First thing is, I think every nation has to have its own AI agency or cabinet level position, something like that. In recognition of how fast things are moving and in recognition of the fact that you can't just do this like with your left hand. You can't just say all the existing agencies, yeah, you can just do a little bit more and handle AI. There's so much going on. Somebody's job needs to be to look at all of the moving parts and say, what are we doing well? What are we not doing well? What are the risks to cybercrime, misinformation? How are we handling these kinds of things? So we need some centralization there, not to eliminate existing agencies, which still have a big role to play, but to coordinate them and figure out what to do. We also, I think, need global AI governance. We don't really want to have, and the companies don't really want to have, different systems in every single country. So for example, it's very expensive to train these models. If you have 193 countries with 193 different regimes requiring so much, you know, damage to our climate and maybe updating them every month or whatever, that would be just a climate disaster. So, you know, we want some international coordination. And then another thing that I think is important for each nation, and maybe we do this globally, is I think we need to move to something like an FDA model, where if you're going to do something that you deploy at wide scale, you have to make a safety case. So sure, you can do research in your own labs. Google doesn't have to tell us everything they're doing. OpenAI doesn't have to tell us everything they're doing. But if they're going to put something out for 100 million users, we really want to make sure it's safe and ask, what are the risks here? What are you doing about those risks? Right now, the companies are doing those things internally, but we need to have external scientists who can say, hey, wait a minute. And I'll give you an example. There's something called ChatGPT plugins, which has now given rise to something called AutoGPT, which can access your files and the internet and even other human beings. Any external cybersecurity expert would say, there's a lot of risk here. But the companies, OpenAI, went ahead and said, it's fine, we can do this. Whereas Apple says, you know, we have to sandbox every application. We have to limit what its access is. So like OpenAI has done something completely at odds with best practice that we know elsewhere in the software industry, and there's no constraint on that and could actually lead to pretty serious harm. And so there are cases like these where we really need some external advisory that can say, this isn't good enough. Sort of like peer review. You know, you don't just publish a paper, you have people examine it. We need to do the same thing. You can't just put something out. And if you affect 100 million users, you really affect everybody. So just as one example, these systems are going to affect people's political opinions. So everybody, even if they signed up or not, is going to be affected by what these systems do. We have no transparency. We don't know what data they're trained on. We don't know how they're going to influence the political process. And so that affects everybody. And so we should have some oversight about it.